Today I'm going to talk to you guys about a new proposal that's been getting more popular within the last few elections. It's called fair tax. Just out of curiosity, has anyone ever heard of fair tax or know about it? Give you? Oh, cool. Very good. All right, I'm sure most of us can recall when we read in our history books about taxes being an issue even in the New World when America was first originally starting. In fact, colonists originally moved over here because of the flaws of taxation in England. Also, you'll recall the Sugar Act, the Stamp Act, and the Boston Tea Party all revolving around taxes, even the 16th Amendment. Right now, the current tax system is flawed. In result, we've been in a deficit, even in a recession, and we need a solution, and that solution is fair tax. Fair tax is going to be simple. It can balance the budget. It's going to it's going to stimulate the economy, and it'll be indiscriminate to social classes. So the best thing that we can do is to support fair tax and vote for those who do support it as well. Hopefully we can start moving along and fix our taxation system. According to Georgia Senator Saxby Chambliss, this should eliminate all federal taxes, income taxes, payroll taxes, capital gains taxes, basically all the tax that we have now is going to just do away with the exception of sales tax. And that sales tax, according to Saxby Chambliss in his article April 15, 2010, the only tax would be sales tax, and that would be set at 23%. Right now, the current tax system, as I said before, has like income, payroll, and capital gains taxes, and that's all taxed based off what you earn, what you work for. The whole theory of fair taxes is going to be taxed off of what you spend, therefore you can potentially save more if you don't spend as much. So, the cool thing about fair taxes, there would be no need for the IRS, it would be done away with. It would repeal the 16th Amendment and still draw the same federal revenues, according to Hemingway in his Comments to the Fair Tax article, Volume 59, Issue 16. Senator Chambliss also stated that it would create a fair, simple tax code that would allow every American the freedom to determine his or her own priorities and opportunities. In other words, like I said earlier, you can have the potential to save more. You can kind of determine where you want that money to go instead of always having it to go to the government. Obviously, anytime you spend, it's going to go. Some of that's going to go 23%. So another cool thing is you can see 100% of your paycheck. Pretty cool, I think. Fair tax could possibly decrease the national debt. At least I think it would, along with Senator Saxby Chambliss. Also, a simulation was done with Jakish Sabin and Laura J. Kotov. I'm sorry if I mispronounced that. They were saying that simulation, in their article simulating the dynamic macro and micro effects of fair tax, Volume 60, Issue 2, 2007, that it would raise long capital gains, intensity long run real wages by 25%. So quarter of 100%, generate major welfare gains and small transition costs with fair tax. Our goal, fair tax promotes shock therapy. On the 23rd of February 2009, says that there'd be no loopholes. In other words, that even immigrants and illegal aliens would not, those who normally don't participate, would have to participate. Also, like drug lords and stuff, normally they get out of taxes because they don't really say like how they made that money. Here, they would have to, even if they continue their shady business, they would still have to pay anytime they went and bought goods and services. Senator Saxby Chambliss also, once again, just kind of reiterates that it would be a revenue neutral base, therefore it wouldn't be indiscriminate to social classes. It's 23% across the board. A lot of people think that would be hurtful, or that would like harm the poor. The thing is, like, the poor people won't typically drive around Ferraris. They're not going to buy most expensive things at stores or have the most fancy vacations. So even though it might seem like a lot to the poor, they're not going to be buying high-priced items as the rich would. So the rich would still be carrying most of the load because they're buying the most expensive things, therefore their taxes won't be so high. So, oh yeah, also, according to a misleading sales pitch, he sees it as like deceptive because he says the added tax is what we think it is, going to be 23%. So 23% is obviously $123, but instead it's really calculated like this. It's the tax off the total. It's going to be 23% of 130, so it'd be a $30 tax, so it'd be $130. So even though this seems deceptive, this is really how income taxes are already calculated. Anyways, as you can see, it would eliminate all federal taxes, income, payroll, self-employment, capital gains, and gift estate. It would break down the IRS, repeal the 16th Amendment, draw same funds according to Hemingway and Comes of Clear Tax 59.18. And I would just advise all of you.